screen, right? Do you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay. So yeah, this was like, this is the track I'm working on. I usually, this is like how my project looks like. It's everything contained in a group arrangement. And yeah, of course you can open and then you have all the things. I usually divide the track in five groups. Now you don't have it here because I still have to, I left it like this, but normally I have a group for drums that you see here, group for kick here, because the kick I layer, here four layers of kick.
Cuatro capas de kick, tiene cuatro diferentes kicks que suenan como uno solo, básicamente.
Yeah. Eso es a bass. Then this is just the original. These are the parts from the original that I took.
Okay. Only that is the original?
Yeah, I use only this for the original.
Okay. Eso es lo único original que tiene del tema en el remix. Algo muy interesante.
Sí. Okay. And here the drums, snare is like layered in, you know. It's all, I will show you right now.
How many tracks do you have in there? What?
82.
79. That should be illegal.
82.
And then, illegal.
As you can see here, the audio doesn't come out from this one. It's like audio to sense only. I open the sense, so I have everything in the master bus.
Why is that? Interesting.
Because first of all, it's gonna sound better, I tell you. Second, can have master and pre-master at the same time from the same project, so don't need to open twice, you know.
Okay. Ahí here, lo que está mencionando es algo que a mí, yo no lo había visto nunca. Procesa todo como un gran grupo. El audio va a los envíos, en caso solamente tiene un envío que es el A. Y ese A es, de nuevo, digamos, todo ya con un pre-master, y luego tiene el master, entonces puede constatar muy rápido el pre-master del master. Muy interesante, no lo había visto nunca.
Sí, porque aquí tengo ozone para hacer el master. Sí. Fuck. Yeah, I have ozone for the mastering. I mean, this is like homemade master I do myself.
Yes.
And... And yeah, I mean, from here you can see the master bus.
Yes.
It was -6. So if I wanna have the master, I just turn this on, and it sounds like a master. Or I turn it off, and then I will export only pre-master. You know.
Okay. Es una manera de you do that, because doing that you can export with one project mix and master. Am I correct?
Yes.
De esa manera lo que puede lograr es con un solo proyecto exportar el pre-master para un label o el ya masterizado. Muy interesante. Yes.
And then, in a way, I have the feeling like this, it sounds better on the master. Like, you know, like having everything going here and it's not direct to the master.
Okay. Siente que suena mejor. Yo lo voy a probar. I'm going to prove it really, because... It's
so I'm gonna show you the track now.
Okay.
Which is a remix I've done for Goose, a band from Belgium. Okay. It's mostly like a rock electronic, but I made my version.
Okay.
And here you can hear the sound I record from the robot.
The Dust Robot.
Yeah, which I called Riot Sound. So and then it's processed like this.
Oh, okay.
So in the inputs I have all the sound from the robot, and then I all process, and then it sounds like this, which is like my main sound at the moment. And I call all the track, when you see Riot, for example, this is like Heaven. The track, the original title is Heaven Riot Mix. So it means that I use this sound, and also like. On the Turbo release, I did Riot Revolt. Now on the Heirloom is gonna be Riot Disco. It's all because I use this sound, which is like for me, and it was like a riot.
Okay.
And also, as it's not so common as a music, you can hear like this so much. It's a revolt to, you know, like in my head, I was like, you know, I want to do this kind of thing. So okay. The riot sounds like this. I don't know if you can hear.
Yes, we're hearing.
You see, there's like a bass sound.
Yes.
It's like, you know, this kind of things. It's more
kind of drum.
Yeah, it's more like sounds like a vocoder, sounds like a percussion, sounds like a bass. But yeah, I will show you the track. So the track is this one. And then we get into details for a little bit.
Okay.
Can you hear it well?
I
encantó. Me encantó. No sé ustedes, pero me pareció muy increíble el hecho de que tenga tantos canales y a la vez suene tan, tan bien, no está lleno de cosas por demás. It sounds really good and they have like 80 channels, but it not feels like very, very
yeah, cool. It's because you need to really, like, then we will get into the mix section, but you know, like, it's important when you think about the track, you have every element needs to have a certain space, you know, like, and for example, like this part doesn't have a bass, no? It's just a kick drum.
Okay.
And the bass drum, the real bass drum, comes only here. You know, like the sub, this one. You know, this one, it makes a difference.
Oof, you did that.
Yeah. So basically, it's just, you know, as you can see, I'm trying to build a new style as a producer.
Yes.
It's my own style, like the track begins in a way and then it ends up in a different way. Still here, change again, you know, and the break here is, you know, there's a different things, but in general, it's muy importante to create your own sound, because all the sounds I use here, I'm using sometimes in new tracks. So what I do, I save a lot of the sounds. So if you see here, I have my favorite things, the external instruments thing, so I can make my own, you know, presets and everything. It's really important for you guys, new producer, and that you can, you know, just starting collecting the sounds, and then you can use it for different productions. That's how you build
an identity. Yes. Ahí es muy importante lo que menciona, que cuando tengan un sonido que esté bueno y les guste, que no muera en ese proyecto, sino que se lo guarden, digamos, lo guarden en live para volver a utilizarlo en otros proyectos y de a poquito ir formando la identidad. A mí me pasó, escuchándolo, que me suena increíblemente como viejo y nuevo a la vez. It's like new and old at the same time. It's like a Depeche Mode combined with Ancients of Time, combined with really good mixing and really nice synth sounds. It's really nice. I feel that old, new style very well mixed, I think.
Yeah, it's that was the first trying to do something cool, and you know, you will see later from one track, but like I'm doing now, it has a certain it follows step by step, and then you can hear like the full picture. You know, it's always like an artist, same as when you send demos demos to labels, they want to hear you in a complete version. So that's why you need to send, of course, more than one track. You need to hear the whole thing, you know?
Okay. There, a friend of mine, Juan, asked if it is possible to quickly hear each of the kicks, because he heard the four layer thing and he's curious. Maybe we can end the chat with just the overview of the kicks if you want, of course.
Of course. So the kick is separate. It's like, as you can hear here, like it starts in this way. I'm gonna zoom in.
Yes.
So it's all audio. I don't have any you know, MIDI or anything.
And that's from the Electron?
I don't even know.
Okay.
Probably it's the TR-8S.
Okay.
Anyway, what I did here, I show you. I just separate the kick. The low ones are like not playing every 4/4. It's just one here and one here. So it's like this layer is a volume, this layer is another volume. So it gives a different dynamic. So when, for example, For instance, if you listen to the kick, it's just like a breakbeat, just for, you hear? Then the volume goes up. See? It gives a different, you know, movement.
Yes, yes, yes. I hear what you say.
Yeah, but
you start with that no classic pattern, and then the volume.
Like, it's only like this one. It's like don't, and this one is in the middle. But together they sound like this. No, but in the end they give a different punch. These ones are only the mid and the high. So this one are. It's like more mid. This is really high. Together with this, sounds like this. And of course, on top of that, I did all these things like on the group itself. So it's like kind of gluing all together. But I have to say, these ones are the best. Like I use this one and this one a lot.
Okay. I know the SSL channel from Waves. I didn't use the DVX compressor.
Yeah. And yeah, this gives a bit of more power and punchy. And this one is, I use it more like EQing, you see? Like.
Yes.
Yeah.
Let me write in the chat.
Yeah, but this, I mean.
This is channel and DVX from Waves. Both from Waves.
Yeah, if you turn it off, it sounds like this. It doesn't even sound, you know? But with this chain.
Yes. It's very clear.
It's less powerful. I've equalized the whole thing in this way because, as I said before, here there's no bass. No.
Yes.
So I needed the kick to have this really like low hand, and you know, say something.
Okay.
And you know, having like the bass here.
Perfect. Understand. Ahí menciona que el kick lo tuvo que trabajar mucho y tuvo que sonar. Que tenía que sonar bien porque no había bajo al principio. Si se fijan en los primeros dos minutos, no hay bajo. Entonces, necesita un kick con un buen low end porque si no, no tiene mucho bajo en la canción.
Yeah. And then, you know, in this way, it's like you're able to have like kind of bass from the kick.
Okay.
But then, when this comes here. Like for example, here having the layer this part, I literally deleted the low part. So the kick is not bass anymore, only having the high.
Okay.
It's gonna sound like a filter.
Kind of DJ filtering.
Yeah. And then you know with the bass. Just like and then the mix together is like. I could, for example, even start a track this way.
No? Yes, of course.
And yeah, most important is when the sounds you hear, they sound good, they convince you as a producer, so they let you go ahead with the production. But if they sound not nice, you will never be like, okay, I like this, I wanna continue the track. You know, it's really important.
Yes. Yeah,
that's what I learned, and then you know, like I spend a lot of time in tweaking, not about choosing the sound, but mostly about shaping the sound, which is more important.
Okay.
You can really take whatever you want and then make it whatever you like. And then you know, as I said, this one is a super complicated chain. I have the impulse, I have compressor, I have delay, I have frequency shifter.
You spend a lot of time in tweaking the sound.
Yeah, because in the end. No matter what you want to do, but as you have an identity, you will always try to push the initial sound to what you have in mind and what
okay
way you like to sound. Like, for example, I like a lot how does like my snare, which is like a snare layer to a clap, sounds here.
It's the first like, time I hear a producer liking your snare.
Yeah, I really like it. Because it's, you know, it's like super in your face. So it really depends on what you want to do and, you know, your taste and your, that's everything, basically.
Okay. Well, we have the last question there. If you know the answer, if you test both, it's a question about the 101, the Behringer or the boutique.
I'm not a big fan of Behringer. Like, I know it might sound like old and stuff, but I don't know. Behringer for me, I was there when I was like the DJ Mixer, the DJX 700, which was like the, you know, like the copy of the Pioneer. I never liked this idea of copying, even in machines. And this really is stealing, you know, it's not like even cloning. Like, I don't know.
Yes, I understand. It's a very common thought in music production. But
yeah, but of course it's analog and maybe it's gonna sound nice, but for the, I don't know, I'm not like a big fan of that.
Yes, that's why I choose the MAM M33 and not the Behringer, like the 303, because I could not afford the original.
I would say take the Atlantis, which is the modular, is like even better than the original 101, kind of. You
know? Okay. Well, again, thank you a lot for this communication. For me, it was really nice. It was a lot of things, very interesting. Gracias también a toda la gente que se recontra sumó y estuvieron un montón de tiempo, en momentos que quizás son complicados acá en Argentina y demás. Nada, realmente agradecerte personalmente como persona porque, nada, es muy fácil trabajar así con gente que tiene ganas de trabajar y tiene buena onda, así que I hope you see back here in Argentina as soon as possible, and really thank you for
being here. It's one of my favorite countries. I love it so much, like the meat, asado, like the wine,
yes.
The parties are amazing, crazy, like,
perfect.
It's one of my favorite for sure, like it's my heart. Also, like Italy and Argentina has a certain connection. So
perfect. We will be waiting for you with an asado, with a meat for you here with the guys from the school.
We can do like a tech asado at the school or something.
Yes, of course. Well, no, thank you to all.
Thank
really.
You for coming. Thank you for having me. And I hope you enjoyed this talk. And hope to see you soon, guys.
Yes, you have people from Mendoza, you have people from Cordoba here, all the country.
That's so nice.
Bueno, muchas gracias a todos. Nos vemos. Gracias a todos por estar. Abrazo grande.
Abrazo.